Hello, welcome to today's video, where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. Today we'll be discussing file objects, and how they can be used to make working on your webcomic easier. Links to additional tutorials and information for everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description below. So what exactly are file objects? A file object is a file with the unique property of being able to be edited in real time after being placed on the canvas. In this example, I've drawn a poster with some text on a wall. If I wanted to skew the wall to change its perspective, the poster would be skewed too. But what if I decided I wanted to change the writing on the poster? Since it's already been skewed, I'd either have to undo all my work or try to write it skewed myself, which would be a hassle. This problem could be prevented by using file objects. This time, I'll draw the wall and poster separately. Then, I'll turn the poster into a file object. This will open the poster up onto its own canvas, where I can write whatever I want on it. What makes file objects useful is that any changes I make to the object file are immediately transferred to the original file upon saving. So let's say I decide I want to skew the wall like I did before, but then realize I want to change the text on the poster. As you can see, I can easily rewrite the text on the poster through the file object file, and those changes will be skewed for me without me having to do any additional steps or undos. This is only one example of the many practical uses file objects have. With a little creativity, you could find lots of uses for them that will save time and effort when making your webcomic. To make a new file object, create a new layer or select a layer or folders of layers you want to convert, then right-click and go to File Object, Convert Layer to File Object. This will open up a menu of settings. The dropdown will determine what area of your canvas will become a file object. Choose Canvas Size to select the entire canvas, or Drawing Area to just select the places you've already drawn on the layer. The Copy Paper Settings box and Copy Crop Mark / Default Border Settings box will duplicate your canvas settings onto the new file, and the Keep Original Layer box will create a new file object while still preserving the original rasterized layer on your original canvas. This should bring you to your file's Device Explorer, where you can save your new file. Make sure to save it somewhere you won't forget it. I always keep mine in the same folder as my comic materials so I can stay organized. If you happen to move your file object to another location on your device later, you can inform Clip Studio Paint of the change by right-clicking the layer and going to File Object, Change File of File Object. Right-click on your file object layer, which is indicated by this symbol, and click File Object, Open File of File Object. Now your file layer is open in a new tab and it's ready for editing. After drawing on your file object, you can either inform your original file of any changes by saving or by right-clicking the file object layer on your original canvas and going to File Object, Update File Object. For your convenience, it may be helpful to create a shortcut button for this option in your quick access menu or command bar so you can make frequent updates quickly. Now you can adjust your file object layer on your original canvas, and by updating the file object file, those changes will be transferred over instantly. You may be surprised to learn just how many Clip Studio Paint features are compatible with file objects. Here's a small list of some features and materials you can combine with file objects for your projects. Speech balloons and text. Transformations, excluding the Mesh Transformation tool. 3D characters, objects, and backgrounds. Color adjustments through the use of clipping masks. Layer masks and layer color settings. One notable limitation to keep in mind is that all filters under the Filter menu are disabled when using file objects. To work around this, I recommend adjusting your workflow so that filters are the last step of your process. That way you can simply rasterize your file object once it's adjusted how you like, then add any filters from there. Those are the basics for how I use file objects to make my webcomic process easier in Clip Studio Paint. In the next video, I'll be giving some examples of how file objects can be used in webcomics for clothing, backgrounds, and sound effects. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.